Hello students, Christian here with you today for the CETIS design team at the College of Allied Health Sciences. And in today's episode, we're going to be talking about how students can host and record WebEx meetings. So here at the University of Cincinnati, students have access to their own personal WebEx meeting rooms with the capacity to host up to 8 individual participants per WebEx session. Now through these sessions, students can collaborate virtually, present their desktops, PowerPoint presentations, and videos, as well as pass presentership rights to anyone in the room. This is a huge win when it comes to group projects, interviews, and role plays. And with that in mind, students can also choose to record their WebEx sessions for future use or to upload to a Blackboard assignment. So let's get started. Logging in to host a WebEx meeting as a student can be completed in 3 simple steps. Number 1, go to ucinstudents.webex.com, and that's U-C-I-N-N students, S-T-U-D-E-N-T-S, .webex.com. Once on the website, click Login. And then you can click on the green Start Meeting button. Simple as that. You're now hosting a WebEx meeting. But wait, what about the other participants? Well, you can either choose to send out your personal meeting room URL to other participants ahead of time by following the same steps above, only instead of clicking on the green Start Menu button, you can click on the More Options button below. Copy the meeting room URL and either email, text, or upload that to Blackboard. That way your meeting participants can just click the link and join your meeting. Now, you can also choose to send a meeting invite after you've started your meeting. Once you're in the meeting room, click on the Invite/Remind option from the meeting room window. Enter the participant names, and an email invite will be sent. All right, so now let's go back to talking about how to host the meeting. Once you've started your meeting, you'll be asked to connect your audio and video. Follow the on-screen prompts to connect these devices. If the prompt doesn't automatically pop up asking you to connect, click on the first icon on the left labeled Connect Audio. Once connected, you can click on the audio option from the top level menu to adjust your settings or choose a different microphone or default speakers. Now, let's connect your webcam. Most laptops these days come equipped with an integrated webcam, or you can choose to purchase your own for under about $30 from Amazon, Staples, or any other store that carries computer peripherals. With your webcam connected to the computer through USB or by using the integrated webcam on your laptop, click on the camera icon in the upper right of the meeting room window near your name. Your webcam will then be displayed. Now, you may be asking, what if I'm on a mobile device? Well, click on the little eye icon in the upper right-hand corner of this video to watch our walkthrough on using a mobile device with WebEx. Okay, so you've logged into WebEx, you've connected your audio, you've connected your video, and your participants are joining. Now it's time to record the meeting. You can click on the recording icon beneath your name and the meeting room information on the left-hand side, or you can click on the icon in the upper right. By clicking on either icon, you'll be prompted that WebEx is connecting to the recording server. And when the little icon turns red, you know that you're recording the meeting. When you're ready to stop recording, simply click the icon again. Now, after you stop recording, if you choose to start recording a second time, that's going to create a separate video clip. But wait, where do these recordings go? Well, I'm glad you asked. All WebEx recordings are uploaded to your Kaltura My Media account found in Canopy. Didn't know you have one? Go to canopy.uc.edu, log in, and click on the My Media link under Tools on the far left-hand side of your screen to view all your recorded media through either WebEx or Kaltura. If you'd like to upload any of these recordings as an assignment to Blackboard, follow these steps. Log into your course. Click on the Assignment, Discussion Board, Quiz, or Assessment link. Click on Write Submission. Then choose the Mashup tool from the toolbar and click on Kaltura Media. Then select your recorded meeting from your media library. When you're ready, click Submit. All right, so I hope you found this tutorial helpful, and as always, if you have further questions, please speak with your course facilitator. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.